In Lab 0, we will learn how to create a project for the STM32 microcontroller using the STM32Cube IDE. We will also learn how to create a sample application for the sensor expansion board using the XCube MEMS1 package. The application will collect the data from all sensors and it will print all measurements on the serial terminal. We will be using the sensor expansion board IKS01A3. On this board there are 6 different sensors. First, an inertial measurement unit, LSM6DSO. This is an accelerometer and a gyroscope with best-in-class power and noise performance. Second, an accelerometer, LIS2DW12. This accelerometer has multiple low power and low noise modes to satisfy all applications. Third, an ambient pressure sensor, LPS22HH. Its accuracy is so high that it can sense variations in altitude of only 5 centimeters, that is a couple of inches. Fourth, a magnetometer, LIS2MDL. The intrinsic offset is compensated internally. It is low noise and it can be used in e-compass applications. It has also a very large dynamic range, 50 Gauss. Therefore, it can be used as a contact or distance sensor with respect to an external magnet. Fifth, a contact temperature sensor, STTS751. This is typically used to monitor the temperature of components which do not have an embedded temperature sensor. In this case, it is reporting the temperature of the expansion board itself. Sixth, a relative humidity and ambient temperature sensor, HTS221. This completes the set of sensors to cover both motion and environmental applications. In this lab, the application will simply read the data from all sensors and print all measurements on the serial terminal. In order to better understand the steps that we will take in the STM32Cube IDE, it is better to have a look at the documentation of the XCube MEMS package. Go to your user folder and look for the following path. STM32Cube. Repository. Packs. STMicroelectronics. XCube MEMS1. Go to the documentation folder, and open the PDF document in it. This document describes in details all sample applications and all the steps that are needed to include them in your project. For the purpose of this video, the most important information is in Figure 11 at page 54. Figure 11 shows the pinout of the IKS01A3 expansion board. In the top right corner, one can see the block for the I2C bus. This bus connects the microcontroller to all sensors on the expansion board. It is made of 2 lines, a serial clock line and a data clock line. The serial clock line correspond to pin D15 on the expansion board and is connected to pin PB8 of the microcontroller. The serial data line correspond to pin D14 on the expansion board and is connected to pin PB9 of the microcontroller. Just remember PB8 and PB9. Now we can begin. Launch the STM32Cube IDE. If it is the first time that you run the IDE, you will see 3 big blue buttons, the first on the left to start a new project from scratch, the second in the middle to start a new project from an IOC file generated by CubeMX, and the third on the right to import a project from other IDEs such as System Workbench or Atolic True Studio. Click on the first big blue button to start a new STM32 project. Alternatively, you can click on the File menu, select New, and then STM32 Project. The IDE may try to check if some update is available. If the network settings are not configured, the IDE will ask to configure them. You can safely cancel the operation as we have already downloaded everything we need. Wait for the IDE to load the list of microcontrollers and development boards. Then click on Board Selector. In the search field, type L476. L476 is the part number of the microcontroller on the Nucleo board. A short list of matching boards will appear. Select the Nucleo L476 from the list. Click on the Nucleo L476 item to confirm, then click on Next. Type the name of the project and then click Finish. Accept the default initialization for all peripherals. At this point, the CubeMX embedded in the Cube IDE may try again to check if some update is available. If the network settings are not configured, the IDE will ask to configure them. You can safely cancel the operation as we have already downloaded everything we need. Wait for the project to be generated. When you see the graphical representation of the microcontroller, you can zoom in with the mouse wheel. Look for PB8 and PB9 on the top edge of the microcontroller. PB8 and PB9 are the pins of the microcontroller that are connected to the I2C communication bus. This bus goes from the microcontroller to all sensors on the expansion board. Click on PB9 and select the I2C1 serial data line function. Click on PB8 and select the I2C1 serial clock line function. PB8 and PB9 are now connected to the internal I2C1 peripheral. The color of the pins is yellow-orange because the internal peripheral is not enabled yet. To enable the I2C peripheral, go to the left panel. Click on Connectivity. Then click on I2C1 to open the corresponding mode and configuration window. In the window, select I2C from the pull-down menu. Note that the color of the pins becomes green. The color becomes green because the internal peripheral to which they are connected is now enabled. We are now ready to bring in the additional software from the XCubeMEMS package. Click on Additional Software near the top of the window. Click on the arrow corresponding to XCubeMEMS. First, we need to bring in the low-level drivers for the sensors on the expansion board. Click on the arrow corresponding to board extension and select IKS01A3. IKS01A3 is the part number of the expansion board. Second, we need to bring in the high-level application code. Click on Device Application. Applications can be found in the pull-down menu. To be able to see the full name of the application, you may need to adjust the width of the columns. Select the data log terminal application for the IKS01A3 expansion board. Finally, click OK and you are back to the main window. We have brought in the drivers and the application code, but we need to enable them. Go to the left panel. Scroll down. Click on Additional Software. Then click on STMicroelectronics XCubeMEMS to open the corresponding mode and configuration window. In the mode window, click the checkbox to enable the expansion board drivers and the application code. In the configuration window, we must select from the pull-down menus the pins that the application must use. The first item is the pin associated with the user button on the Nucleo board, PC13. We need to specify the output serial peripheral, asynchronous UART number 2. We need to specify the input communication bus, I2C1. Finally, the pin associated with the green LED on the Nucleo board, PA5. We can now save the project, which will trigger the actual generation of the code. The code is now generated. Expand the core folder. Then expand the source subfolder. Double-click on main.c. You will see the generated code. User code can be added between sections marked as user begin and user end. User code added inside these sections will be kept when the project is regenerated, while user code added outside these sections will be lost. We can now build the project and create the binary. No other project should be open while we build this project. Click on the hammer icon on the top. In the console, you can verify and monitor the compilation process. The compilation should be completed with no warnings or errors. Now it is the time to connect the Nucleo board with its expansion to your computer by plugging the USB cable. When the board is connected, we can flash and debug our application. Click on the bug icon on the top, then click OK on the pop-up window. The firmware binary is programmed into the target microcontroller and run. The debugger will halt the execution at the first breakpoint, that is at the beginning of the main function. Click the play button to go past the breakpoint and let the firmware run. Now the firmware is running. Let's check the output. Minimize the CubeIDE window and launch the serial terminal emulator, TeraTerm. We need to open a new connection to the serial port associated with the Nucleo board. Click on the File menu, and select New Connection. Click on the radio button on the bottom, which corresponds to connections over the serial link. Click on the pull-down menu to the right, to see the list of available COM ports. The COM port associated with the Nucleo board is named STMicroelectronics Virtual COM port. It is virtual because it is emulated over the actual USB connection. As soon as the serial terminal emulator is connected to the serial port of the Nucleo board, you should see the flow of data. If the serial port settings are not correct, the characters cannot be received in the correct way from the serial link, and the data will be unreadable. Click on the Setup menu and select Serial Port. In the dialog window, set the COM port speed to 115,200 bits per second, 8 data bits, no parity, 1 stop bit, no flow control. Then click on the New Setting button to confirm. The flow of data should now be clearly readable. To avoid to repeat this serial port setup every time you are connected to the virtual COM port of the Nucleo board, it is better to save it. Click on the Setup menu and select Save Setup. Save the setup to the default TerraTerm.ini file, so that when you run TerraTerm the next time, it will automatically connect to the same serial port with the same serial port settings. When you are done, go back to the IDE and click on the Stop button to stop debugging. We can now close the project. Right-click on the project name and select Close. Thank you.